If you'd have told me 2 years ago that I would be making a video on the EmDrive, I would have exclaimed the word preposterous, along with much chortling and scoffing. The reason being was that I was very skeptical of this technology. I had good reason. It outright violates the laws of physics as it was described. And not just any physics, but basic Newtonian physics that have weathered the test of time for centuries. So in my gray basket, the EmDrive sat, nestled up with cold fusion, keeping it warm. That was until NASA got involved. Then my eyebrow rose, just a little. Up until that point, the EmDrive question was dominated by a small group of individuals that seemed a bit fringe and also didn't seem too interested in peer review. But now that NASA was interested, that put the idea into a slightly different ballgame. While that didn't mean that the EmDrive works, there seemed to be enough there for NASA's engineers to go for it and test it out because of the great potential that such a drive held for space exploration. The odd thing is, NASA concluded that the EmDrive does indeed work. Now, I took that with a grain of salt. It was interesting, they even tested one successfully in a vacuum, but NASA scientists are scientists, and peer review is everything. But now something seems to have happened that may change the game significantly. The NASA EagleWorks EmDrive research team's paper has reportedly passed peer review and is being published. Apparently, the EmDrive officially works. Before we go on, here's a simplified explanation of how the EmDrive operates. The EmDrive is what's called a reactionless drive. Now, these should not work. Newtonian conservation of momentum requires that in a closed system, such as a car or spacecraft, linear and angular momentum stay the same no matter what happens inside. In other words, if you push on your car's steering wheel, the car does not go faster. Newton's third law states that for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. This is how rockets work. There is an action, i.e. burning fuel, and then a reaction, i.e. thrust and movement. EmDrives are reactionless. I'm sure you see the problem with that. The EmDrive is what's called an RF resonant cavity thruster. These work by taking a magnetron, the same thing that makes your microwave oven work, and firing microwaves at a metal cone mounted to it, pushing against it and propelling the whole assembly forward. This should not work, but apparently it does. But Newtonian physics also works really, really well. Because of that, we have to go in search of some way that this whole thing happens that stays within the laws of physics. It's highly unlikely that the same physics that allowed us to land on the moon and build safer automobiles and countless other things is wrong. Enter a development of a few months ago. Physicist Michael McCullough proposed a new explanation for the EmDrive's apparent success. His theory involves inertia and something called the Unruh effect. I won't go into detail here, it's a difficult concept to explain concisely, but it could theoretically be what's behind the EmDrive's production of thrust. Very theoretically, as much involving the Unruh effect remains in the unconfirmed basket. Long story short, there is now at least a theoretically possible way for the EmDrive to function within the laws of physics. Add that with NASA's work passing peer review, and we're now in interesting territory to be sure. Now you may be asking, what does the EmDrive offer us if it pans out? Quite a lot. For one, it's very fast. It would allow us to reach points in our solar system in a few months that used to take years to reach. More, it eliminates fuel as a variable in designing a spacecraft, which would make the International Space Station quite a bit cheaper to operate. To run the EmDrive, you just need electricity. That means lighter, faster, and cheaper spacecraft. More, if coupled with another developing technology, could revolutionize space travel and allow dramatically higher travel speeds than we have now with our chemical rockets. The stars may soon be in reach if this all pans out, but a healthy dose of skepticism always pays when moving forward. A lot can still go wrong with these technologies because we're dealing with areas of science we don't yet have a great grasp of. The EmDrive is dependent on electrical energy and won't replace our chemical rocket launch systems. But in space, the more energy you have, or so it is claimed, again, grain of salt until we figure out just how this thing works, the faster you can go. With a nuclear reactor of a type that we use in submarines, the EmDrive could theoretically reach just under 10% the speed of light. Problems with launching nuclear reactors into space aside, we are currently limited by how much energy we can produce in space by the abilities and size of our launch systems and the limits of solar panels. We typically don't have a lot of electricity to work with in space, but this may soon radically change. It's possible that we may be far closer to viable fusion energy than was previously thought. In 2014, Lockheed Martin's Skunk Works, no lightweight for sure, made the claim that they had solved certain technical problems with fusion plasma torusses and have found a way to create fusion energy in a bar plasma configuration. Called Compact Fusion, they claim that within just a few years, they could have an experimental reactor up and running and within a decade have viable, 100-megawatt compact fusion reactors available for use in cities, but it's also compact enough to launch into space. Now, claiming is different than doing, so we just need to see how this Lockheed technology pans out along with the EmDrive. But the possibility is now there that in a decade or so, we may have technology that would allow us to send a probe to our nearest stellar neighbor, Proxima Centauri, and get there in about a century or so. There may be other faster ways of doing that, but that's still a lot better than the 76,000 years it would take Voyager 2. The stars will become a lot closer if the EmDrive works, just not close enough yet. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently with a new book coming out. Stay tuned, and be sure to check out my other books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for in-depth, regular explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.